So I love that you, from day one, you always owned the Scream Queen title. You were always good about it. Your mom, obviously, being one of the great, greatest of all.
Yeah, Farrah. So thank you.
What's fun to
miss
to,
her?
To, yeah, what's fun to revisit it, like in this little.
I've always tried to maintain the idea that we're all trying to get our footing in show business. I don't care who you are. When you start out young, you try to get your footing in show business. And for me, I landed like on a mountaintop at 20. And this, what supported me was a genre that I don't particularly like. I'm not a horror film fan. But the genre supported my work. So for as long as I've been working, I understand that without them, I wouldn't have a career. And I'm grateful. I'm grateful to this unbelievably loyal, devoted fan base, gentle fan base. And so for me, it's a return to them. And it's like going home again. It's like coming home to your very big, crazy, loud, fun, extended family who loves you. And that's how I feel.
What I love about horror movies is that it's really about the survivor. And the survivor is usually not the big strong jock, it's usually a girl, and maybe the girl that no one ever thought of before. So has that been important to you in the
horror genre
and in
not,
the show?
It's not about the end result for me. It's not about being the survivor or not. It's truly because I don't get that involved in it. It's like I'm not that psychologically involved in the genre. I just know that the people that support these movies have supported me since I was 19 years old. And that has given me something that a lot of young women don't get, and I'm grateful for it.
Well, I loved how Halloween H2O was your idea to show Laurie as a traumatized survivor 20 years later.
Well, no, it started with, hey, we're all still in show business 20 years later.
Okay.
Why don't we take advantage of that? That was honestly the pitch. Then the pitch was, if somebody's been traumatized and what happens with trauma, which is you end up self-medicating, and if she had basically self-medicated, then how do you face your fear? How do you face fear? And you face fear by confronting it.
So I'll change my question a little then. Is it almost another 20 years later to Scream Queens, another chance to say, hey, we're still in show? Is it a different approach?
Did you see the show last night?
No.
Okay, then you have no idea. It is a wild ride, and it has no reflection on a classic horror trope. It is wickedly funny and deeply dark and a little violent and super fashion-y, and everything you think about a character does not add up. Like, you think you know Dean Munsch, and then by the end of the episode, you're like, oh. So it's a very, I really urge you guys to have Fox show you the show.
We'll see it, yeah.
Because it is not a classic horror trope at all.
What's been interesting to you working with these young actresses? They kind of told us that you've taken them under your wing.
Well, but I mean, by the way, I'm 56 years old. I have a 28-year-old daughter and a 19-year-old son who's walking around Comic-Con dressed as Trafalgar Law from One Piece. Believe me, I'm going to nest with my little birds. The first day we did... Well, you didn't get to see the show last night. Why wouldn't Fox have you guys see the show?
I asked them for the screener.
That's
crazy. You know, that's
we should get the screener like
we'll
any
get,
day.
We'll yeah. get it for TCA.
Okay, so the first scene I have is with Emma Roberts in my office, and that was the first scene we shot. And it's a 6-page dialogue scene, ping pong match between the two of us. And I'm telling you, we kind of was like, hi, I'm Jamie, I'm Emma, sit down. Ryan's like, okay, let's shoot this. And it was like, okay, boom, hit it. And this girl starts hitting ping pong balls at me, and I'm like, whoa, damn, I'd better pay attention here. Like, no warm-up. Like, she is firing aces at me, and I'm thinking, I'm really got to be on my game here. Like 7:15 in the morning in New Orleans, first day. I'm like, whoa. And that's how it's been with every one of them. Each of these girls has inhabited these people. They've eaten them. And they are just It's like garlic breath. They're just, you know, giving it back to you every second. It's really extraordinary. And I think it just is a testament to a professionalism that young people actually do have that we kind of take for granted. I think it really speaks to Ryan Murphy and Brad Falchuk and Ian Brennan, who have created this sort of triumvirate of talent that are very clear. You need to, we will give it to you, you need to give it back. And therefore it means give it back, know your shit, and deliver it. And that's how I've had an experience with every one of these girls.
Can I just ask real quick, did you and your mom have a conversation about the genre and being in it ever?
No, never. No, she was always grateful for it, I'm grateful for it.